से वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. सो फार वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इट इज मॉड्यूल 4 अपॉन विथ फीडबैक एंड जनरल एप्लीकेशंस. वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वोल्टेज सीरीज एंड शंट फीडबैक. वी डिराइव्ड 4 पैरामीटर्स: क्लोज लूप गेन, इनपुट आउटपुट इंपेडेंस एंड बैंडविड्थ फॉर ऑल द वोल्टेज सीरीज एंड शंट फीडबैक. एंड वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एप्लीकेशंस: एसी डीसी एम्पलीफायर, हाउ टू यूज, हाउ टू मेक ऑफसेट नलिंग and the external techniques used to nullify the offset. And then we discussed about summing amplifier. So in summing amplifier, we come across with 3 configurations: inverting, non-inverting and differential configurations. And we have come across scaling or weighted amplifier, or I can say averaging amplifier. So next we'll move on to, and also we have discussed about differential amplifier as a subtractor and as well as a summing amplifier, and derived expression for output voltage. So next we'll move on to the next application. Important application in day-to-day life is instrumentation amplifier. I hope you can observe in these 2 pictures. The first picture is going to measuring some voltage or current. So that is just I want to tell you about measuring instruments. So what you can observe in many industrial and consumer applications: the measurement and the control of a physical conditions. The physical condition may be a temperature or humidity, etc., are very important. For example, you can observe in this slide one more thing. This is just an example, have an EEG signal. Okay, here you can observe the 2 electrodes are connected to the human hand. The positive is this, and again this positive. This is, these 2 are voltage follower. So whatever the voltage you are getting, that will be fed to a output of these 2 op-amp, and that will be fed in turn to a inverting amplifier. So we'll see that a different scenario. So now here it is, you can observe the right leg is connected to ground. So here it is the circuit of minimizing common mode interference. So here not only you are taking or measuring a person, I can say it is like a electrodes. So here you are giving some voltage here. So here you are having measuring the 2 hands. Yes, mute yourself. So we'll take up this example later. So here my intention is to today we are going to discuss about instrumentation amplifier. What exactly the instrumentation amplifier, what is the function, what are the applications, and what are the advantages over differential amplifier. And then we are going to derive an expression for a simple instrumentation amplifier using a resistive transducers. Again, here transducers plays a major role. Then what is a block diagram of an instrumentation amplifier, and then you are going to have derive an expression by keeping in the mind resistive transducer, Wheatstone bridge network. We are going to discuss, you are going to find output voltage and where exactly you required an instruments to measure a physical changes. Can you tell me what are the physical changes? Yes, it's not only to measure a multimeter. Don't keep instruments means only multimeter to measure voltage, current, resistance, etc. It's not only electrical measurements, it can also be used to measure physical changes. Let me know, what are the physical changes? Anyone?
Temperature.
Yes.
Very good. Temperature,
pressure.
Yes, displacement, torque, or sometimes flow. So that is, I want to tell you about in sugar factory, if I require a measurement of a flow or a level or a temperature of a juice. So next, coming to plastic furnaces, you require a precise measurement of a temperature. And coming to dairy plant, it requires precise measurement of temperature and as well as humidity, because you need to maintain the milk products, or sometimes a meat. So you required a precise measurement of temperature. Precise means accurate temperature and humidity, And also it is mainly this is going to help these measurements or physical changes or this measurements will be help the industries to have the production of quality products. If you want to give a production of the good quality products, we should maintain a certain temperature, or it may be based on the application a requirement, you need to maintain temperature or humidity. So here whatever the changes are physical things we are talking here, so our instruments won't measure directly. So what it is going to do is, you require a transducer, you have studied in your EI subject PE and EI. So it's a device which converts one form of energy into another form. So how it is going to convert? For example, if I take a thermocouple, so it is going to be converts heat energy into electrical energy. Similarly, microphone is going to convert sound energy into electrical energy. Like this, one form of energy into another form. And similarly, strain gauge. So strain gauge is going to convert. It's like a strain gauge means it is going to have elongation or compression on the force applied. So it converts a pressure or a force like a mechanical energy into electrical energy. As you know that pressure and force will talking in terms of mechanical energy that will be converted into electrical energy. So these are the example for your transducers, that is thermocouple, microphone and strain gauge. So why I am talking here the transducers is, and how instrumentation amplifier interlinked. So you can observe in this image, this is a general block diagram of an instrumentation amplifier. So I told you transducer, that is your input stage. So input stage, the physical quantity to be measured. So what will be the physical quantity? As you told, temperature, pressure, it may be displacement, torque, anything. So force, anything you can, is a physical quantity. If you want to measure any physical quantity to be measured, that will be the input to the first stage. The first stage is a transducer, or it will be having inbuilt pre-amplifier. So what will happen when you measure a temperature around in the scenarios, or you can say if at present if I measure a temperature, so you may get due to some interference or some noise. If I take a sound microphone, if you record your voice, due to noise it won't be clear, noise will be added, so your signal will be very less in strength. If you want to amplify that, you will be going with an instrumentation amplifier. It is going to amplify the small differential signals and is going to have high CMRR. So in talking about instrumentation amplifier, this is an important parameter, common mode rejection ratio. It should cancel out any signals that have the same potential on both the inputs and amplifies the potential difference between the inputs. Just remember, it is an amplifier. It is going to amplify the low level signals, that is also going to amplify the difference between the two inputs. You can observe, you are giving two inputs here, that will be given input to the indicator or automatic process controller. Remember, instrumentation amplifier is going to output is to an indicator or automatic process controller. So what will happen without this instrumentation amplifier? For example, if the transducer is directly connected to an indicator, so indicator means your display or automatic process controller, what will happen? Any idea? Without instrumentation amplifier, directly if you connect an indicator, just a display, whatever you are measuring, a quantity, physical quantity, temperature, pressure, force, it will be displayed on the indicator. Is it a precise measurement? Yes. No, that is a very low value, low level. So that is not accurate and it is not precise. If you want to make it is a precise and accurate measurement, you need to boost up the signal strength. And then you can observe here, I have written your circled one. So that is a transmission lines. Any idea about transmission lines? What is the use of transmission lines?
used to transmit data, ma'am.
Yes, transfer data from one unit to other unit. Good. So here, this connecting lines between the blocks, you can observe the two ovals, that is transmission lines, between the input state and the intermediate stage, and between the second and the third stage also, I have written transmission lines. Mainly, I can say this, especially when the transducer is at a remote test site, monitoring hazardous conditions. Let me repeat. A transducer at a remote level, test site monitoring hazardous conditions like high temperatures or liquid levels of flammable chemicals. So if you, whenever you want to measure a high temperature one or liquid levels of flammable chemicals, itara chemicals agirbodu athwa high temperature na hatra nintu measure madakagala. So you should be remote. So remote test site monitoring, I can say. So what these transmission lines will do is, it is going to permit a signal transfer from unit to unit. So again, the question will arise, what is the length of a transmission line? Is it any fixed length? So just now told high temperature, liquid, it varies. So it is varies on the physical measurement, how we are going to measure. So if you want to measure high temperature, you require a longer distance or longer length, or it is normal one, you can measure it with a smaller length. So length of a transmission line depends primarily on the physical quantities to be monitored and system requirements. Requirements ya tara bekagutto aa tara will be using a length of a transmission line. There is no fixed in length. So it is be 10 meter, 100 meters, you can't say. It is based on a physical quantity you are going to measure, and also the system requirements. Nam system yav tara irutte remote sensing madodakke aa tara length ge you are going to use a transmission lines. Now is it clear? The input stage is a transducer, and the intermediate stage is our instrumentation amplifier to amplify the signals or small differential signals with high CMRR and a high gain. And the output stage is a indicator and a controller. I can say automatic process controller. This is the main block diagram of a instrumentation amplifier. Then coming to the applications of instrumentation amplifier are, in day-to-day life, it is mostly used in all industrial applications and biomedical. So extensively it is used in biomedical applications. I can say it is everywhere. Is everywhere in all the measuring instruments. So a biomedical applications like ECGs and EEs, electrocardiogram and EEGs, and it is used in automation of long-term industrial stability application. So here it is used in automation of long-term industrial stability applications, and it is also used with incorporation with the pressure transducers in weighing systems to monitor various physical quantities. So weight, maybe in terms of force, pressure, displacement and torque. So it is used as a pressure transducers to measure physical quantities like weight, force, pressure, displacement and torque. It is also used in gaming industry. And coming to the main functions of instrumentation amplifier, as I told you, it is used to amplify low-level signals that is produced by the transducer. And also the instrumentation amplifier is to drive a display or indicator. I hope it is clear here. The indicator has to be driven by a instrumentation amplifier, and it is also going to amplify the signals produced by the transducer. So that is amplify low level signals of the transducer to drive the display or indicator, controlling process indicator. So here our intention is to precise a low level signal amplification with low noise. We can't say it is completely nullifying the noise. We'll be having little bit noise and low thermal and time drift, high input resistance, accurate closed loop voltage gain. It requires a closed loop voltage gain and high input resistance. And as I told you, it is, should have high CMRR and sleeve rate. So sleeve rate plays a major role here. So sleeve rate is rate of change of output voltage, or I can say response. How you are going to change your input, the output has to be effect on the immediate changes in the input. Whenever you are measuring or you are changing the flow, or it may be a temperature, it should immediately show accurate measurements. So high common mode rejection ratio. So common mode rejection ratio come into picture when you are giving two signals of same potential. So it should amplify the difference between that small variation. And that is the main function, is it is not consuming much power. It is a low power consumption device. So as you all know that the instrumentation amplifier IC frequently used are MUA725, ICL7605, LH0036. These three are the ICs used for instrumentation amplifier. Coming to the advantages is, obviously here offset voltage is minimized because it is going to amplify the small difference between the two signals. So offset voltage is minimized and voltage gain is high because it is asking, it is required a closed loop gain, and it is going to use high precision resistors. So here the gain of the circuit can be varied by using again the specific value of a resistor. Whatever the changes happening in the gain, it is based on the resistor itself. So non-linearity is very low here. So it is very linear device. So it is inherent performance limitation of the device and cannot be removed by external adjustment, but it can be designed by the manufacturer. So there is a limitation of the device here. It is, it will not function as a non-linear device. So here, as I told you, input impedance should be very high in order to avoid loading down the input signal source, and the output impedance is very low because it is an operational amplifier based instrumentation amplifier. So input impedance has to be very high and output impedance is very low, because in order to avoid, that's why you are making input impedance very high to avoid the loading effect. That's why you are not placing a high output impedance should be very low, and it is having common mode rejection is very high. So as I told you, here today we are going to have an expression for output voltage using a transducer bridge. I hope you have studied this in your electronic instrumentation. So what type of bridge it is? Yes.
Wheatstone.
Yes, it's Wheatstone bridge. So I can say here it is instrumentation amplifier using a transducer bridge. Just observe the circuit carefully. Yes, can anyone tell me what exactly this circuit? I told you in the basics of an op-amp. Are you remember?
Voltage follower.
Very good. It is voltage follower. We have two voltage followers, and that will be given. Again, can you identify what type of circuit it is? Recently, we come across with this in the last class. Not summing. We come across one more configuration.
Subtractor.
Yes, subtractor can also be called differential amplifier. This is a differential amplifier. We are giving a different voltage to the two terminals. You can observe here the two resistors here and two resistors here. These two resistors are same as these two. R1 is equal to R2, R3 is equal to RF, and you have an indicating meter across the load. I hope the circuit is clear. We are using here Wheatstone bridge. It is a balanced condition, and we are using voltage follower, two voltage followers. The voltage follower means output remains same as the input. Output follows the input. Ilain VAB idyo, same VAB you will get across the voltage follower. Am I correct? Yes. So voltage follower ni vene input kotro, same adhe output parat. Because output follows the input. ಇಲ್ಲಕ್ಕೆ ಬಫರ್. ಸೊ ಬಫರ್ ಥರ ನೀವು ಏನು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ 5 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗೆಟ್ 5 ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ದಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್ ಟು ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೀಟರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಡ್ಯೂಸರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ದ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಟೂ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್. ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೀಟರ್. ನಾನು ಏನು ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಫೀಚರ್ಸು ಈ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಎ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್. ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾಲೋವರ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಬಫರ್. ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫೀಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್. ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಡ್. ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಅ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೀಟರ್. ಸೊ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ನೋ ಹೌ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್? ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ as a function of
pressure.
It may be a pressure, or it may be force, or it may be temperature, any physical quantity. Yes, so a resistive transducer here whose resistance changes as a function of physical energy is connected in one arm. This arm, you can observe here one arm of the bridge with a small circle around it, and it is denoted by RT plus R minus delta R. RT is a resistance of the transducer. RT is a resistance of a transducer, and delta R is a change in resistance. RT. Let me repeat. Resistive transducer whose resistance changes as a function of physical energy that is connected to one arm of a bridge. That is, you can observe with a small circle here. So this, whatever the variation, is denoted by here RT plus R minus delta R. RT is the resistance of a transducer, and delta R is a change in resistance of RT. So this bridge circuit here, this voltage can be a DC excited, or it may be sometimes AC. You can give any source. For this, if you make this bridge balanced at some reference conditions, a condition seen in it, so always you're going to have this node and this node voltage, we call it as VA, and this node voltage we call it as VB. The balanced condition is what? VB is equal to VA. So you have a 2 ohms of bridge. So between this you have 2 resistors. So I can say it is one voltage divider circuit across this left arm, and again this right side you have one more voltage divider circuit. Okay, so now we need to equate what is the value of VB, what is the value of VA. How to find out VB now, tell me, according to voltage divider rule? Is just assume this is a one voltage divider circuit. So your intention is to equate these two values, balanced condition. Balance ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ನ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿರೋ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಸೇಮ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದು ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇರಿಯಿಂಗ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕೀಪ್ ದೀಸ್ 3 ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೇ ವೇರಿ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕೀಪ್ ದೀಸ್ 2 ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿ ಬಿ, ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಎ ಯು ವೋಂಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೋ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್, ದಿಸ್ ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ವೇರಿ. Yes. Is this clear with this circuit? Shall we go with a mathematical analysis?
Yes.
Shall I continue? Yeah. So as I just now told you, if you want to make this bridge balanced, equate VB is equal to VA. So a bridge, you have a bridge like in a diamond shape. So you have two arms. So ikade Ra Rb ittu ikade you have a resistance vary, and this you have a one more resistance here. This is Rb and Rc. This is Rb you had, and this is Rc, and this is Ra. This is Rt plus delta R. So now what you have to do is you need to apply a voltage divider rule. So for this part, so here you are going to apply a DC voltage VDC, and this node we call it as VA. So now if you apply this, keep it in mind, this is grounded. So like that is, it looks like this. Maybe terminals I've written reverse. So this is resistance RC and this is RB. Okay, so this RC is connected to VDC. Now I need to find out this VB. So always voltage divider rule says the supply voltage VDC into the resistance towards ground, VDC into RB by sum of the resistance RB plus RC. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಆರ್ಮಿಗೆ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಡಿವೈಡರ್ ರೂಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸೊ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಯಾವ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ? ಆರ್ ಎ. ಆರ್ ಎ ಇಂಟು ವಿ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಬೈ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟಿ. ನಾನು ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಆರ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಇಸ್ ವೇರಿಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್. So left out is RT, Ra by RT, illi. So you left out with only RC. So you'll get an expression RC by RB is equal to RT by Ra. So don't worry about this expression. Next, is it clear with the voltage divider equations? So first your intention is to balance the bridge. Shall I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
So now, let me take a change in the resistance of the transducer is delta R. And I told you RB and RC are the left arm of a Wheatstone bridge. It is to be fixed resistance. Agle elde nanu ee RC RB values if I take 3k 3k, you will get a VB as a constant. Yes or no? ವಿ ಬಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಬರುತ್ತಾ ಬರಲ್ವಾ? ಆರ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ವಿ ಬಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಾ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ?
ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಎಸ್, ವಿ ಬಿ ಇಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಎ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸೊ ವಿ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೇರೀಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಡ್ಯೂಸರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ದ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಆರ್. ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಆರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟೆಡ್. So previously we written expression Ra by Ra plus Rt into VDC ಬರೆದಿದ್ವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. Now we added the change in resistance delta R. That part also added to resistive transducer or resistance of a this. So now across VB you have same voltage divider rule. ಏನು ಮಾಡಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಬರೆದಿದ್ರು, ಸೇಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್. VB ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಇಂಟು ವಿ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಿ. So next what we have to do is we have to find out what is the output terminal of the bridge. So output terminal of the bridge is, you know, VAB. So output terminal of the bridge is VAB. So VAB indre it is a difference between VA and VB. So that is VA minus VB. The voltage is VA minus VB. So and one more thing you want to make it as assumption. You need to make assumption saying that all resistors are equal. Ra equal Rb equivalent to Rc equivalent to Rt equivalent to some R. Then what will happen? So need to substitute to this equations to Va and Vb. So only R by R plus delta R, R by R plus R. Enagutte R by 2R aitu, Vdc cancel ankondrunu. 2R plus delta R. So ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಆರ್ ವಿ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಬೈ 2R ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಆರ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಿ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಬೈ 2R. So RR get cancelled. So if you take LCM here, 2 into 2R plus delta R is a LCM. So when you cross multiply, you will get this expression. So 2R VDC and 2R VDC cancelled. You will be left out with minus VDC into delta R. So you got an expression as VAB, the difference between the two nodes of a Wheatstone bridge. VAB is equal to minus of VDC into delta R by 2 times 2R plus delta R. So negative sign, why is it so? Because VA now constant and the togondruno, VB lane agide, delta R join agirodrinda, VB voltage jasti irutte. VB andre yav terminal connect madirudido, this VA. So VA is more than this VB. So VB, VA is less than VB. So voltage across A node is less than VB. That's why it is negative sign. So after that, after the Wheatstone bridge, you have a voltage follower. So just it acts as a buffer. Then that followed by a differential amplifier, it is going to eliminate the loading of a bridge circuit. As you all know that the gain of a basic differential amplifier is minus RF by R1 into VA minus VB maadthidvi alva. So that is only the gain of a basic differential amplifier circuit. So V0 is equal to VAB into minus RF by R1. This is the equation for differential amplifier. You can go back and you can look over. Last class we have just come across with this expression. Output voltage is equal to Vx minus Vy we have written. Here now it is VAB. VAB means VA minus VB itself into minus RF by R1. So now, and one more thing is, we are going to approximate 2R plus delta R. Delta R means small change. So when you compare delta R with 2R, which is larger? Which is larger?
2R.
Delta R, 2R jasti. So we are going to equating 2R plus delta R to 2R. So our previous expression again. So this expression, so minus VDC into delta R, e expression VAB substitute madadre. So nimge already il minus ide, a minus minus eliminate agi, RF by R1, delta R by 2 into 2R plus delta R ittalva, a 2R plus delta R na 2R anta tagondre. So you will be getting as 4R agate, 2 into 2R andre 4R, delta R numerator ide into VDC. So here you need to substitute VAB value. So VAB is minus of VDC delta R. So VAB, this is VDC into delta R divided by 2 into 2R plus delta R. This is the value of VAB. So 2R plus delta R na we have taken it as a 2R. So this will become 4R. So E minus plus I to. So you will be getting as RF by R1 delta R by 4R agate, because this is going to be approximated to 2R. 2 to the 4R delta R by 4R into VDC. This is an output expression of a this resistive transducer bridge. Is this clear? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next, you are going to have what are the different types of resistive transducers? So, what we have derived an expression for resistive transducer itself. So we have many different resistive transducers. So resistive transducer means the resistance will vary based on the physical quantity. Physical quantity, due to temperature, your resistance may vary, or due to some lighting effect, I can say light dependent resistors. So light intensity of light in the ಆ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ನ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆಷರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ನೂ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರೆಷರ್, ಕಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲಾಂಗೇಷನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಐಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್, ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಫೋಟೋ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಗೇಜಸ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ಇಟ್, ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಹೌ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಡಿವೈಸ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ತ್ರೀ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಫೋಟೋ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಗೇಜಸ್. ಸೊ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಥರ್ಮಲಿ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್. ಫೋಟೋ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಆರ್. ಸ್ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಗೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ಪ್ರೆಷರ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಷ್ಟೇ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಟೇಕ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಮೆನಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಡಯೋಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯುರೋಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯುಎಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜಪಾನ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಥರ್ಮಲಿ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಹೈ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಐ ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹೈ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್, ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸೆನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಟು ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಎ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್. ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಆಸ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್. ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆದಂಗೆ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಓಮ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಓಮ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡನ್, ದಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಬ್ರಿಕೇಶನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಆನ್ ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಶೇಪ್ಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಶೇಪ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ರೆಕ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಶೇಪ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆನಿ ಶೇಪ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್. ಸೊ ನೀಟಾಗಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಮೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್, ಇನ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಮೌಂಟ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ಥರ್ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಥರ್ಮಲಿ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸೆನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಟು ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್. ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್. ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇದು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆದರೆ ಅದು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಓಮ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಶೇಪ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಮೇಜ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಸೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಸಿ ಟು ಮೌಂಟ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಯೂಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಲೈಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಆರ್, ಲೈಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ತ್ರೀ ನೇಮ್ಸ್, ಫೋಟೋ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಟು ಲೈಟ್, ಸೊ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಫೋಟೋ ಸೆನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವೇರಿ ವಿತ್ ದ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್. ಸೊ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ 100 kΩ ಇನ್ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ನೆಸ್. ಜನರಲಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಇನ್ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ನೆಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ 100 kΩ. ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸೆರಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೇಸ್, ಎ ಲೇಯರ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸೆರಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೇಸ್, ಎ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್. ಸೊ ಬೇಸ್ ಸೆರಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಇದು ಫೋಟೋ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಅಂತಾಗಿ ಕ್ಯಾಡ್ಮಿಯಂ ಸಲ್ಫೈಡು ಮತ್ತು ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಬ್ರಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ CDS, ಕ್ಯಾಡ್ಮಿಯಂ ಸಲ್ಫೈಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಸೆರಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೇಸ್. ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಸೆರಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೇಸು, ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹಾವ್ ಎ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್, ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ನ ಕೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಇನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ. and it is a moisture proof enclosure with a metallic lids. So idike moisture proof maartivi. So you can observe, these are the images of this photoconductive cell. So this is also an example, and these are the exact devices. Looks like these are the LED. Okay, is this clear? So here you need to remember, it is photosensitive device. The resistance varies with the intensity of light, with resistance of 100 kilo ohm in directness, that is general, and it consists of a ceramic base. Over that you are going to have a conductive material, photoconductive material, cadmium sulfide and silicon, and also you'll be having moist proof enclosure with metallic lids. Coming to the third type, strain gauge. Here the resistance changes when elongation and compression taken place. When it will happen? When you apply external stress. Pressure, some material is going to be elongated or compressed. That is will be a strain gauge. So stress, as you know, that is defined as a force per unit area. On what area you are going to apply what force? So stress and rajatane, how much force you are going to put or applied, and what is an area? The area changes. Elongation agata, compression aita, expansion aita, reduce aita, anta yadadike area. So force per unit area, and it can be related to force, it can be related to pressure, displacement, torque. So strain gauge used to measure these physical quantities. So strain gauge na ee physical quantities, so force, pressure, displacement and torque, in order to measure those parameters you are going to use strain gauge. Here if you want to find out the sensitivity of a strain gauge, is unit change in the length per unit change in the resistance. So it is length by R, unit change in length by unit change in resistance. So there are two types of strain gauges, wire strain gauge and semiconductor. So among these two, the semiconductor strain gauges are more sensitive than wire, so in terms of accuracy and resolution. So always we'll prefer a semiconductor strain gauge than wire strain gauge. Is this clear? So this is about instrumentation amplifier and different types of resistive transducers. Any doubt? Yes?
No, ma'am.
Is this clear? Okay, so this is what we have discussed about today's session. These questions are based on today's sessions. Let's try to answer this. A strain gauge is an example of which device? Options: transducer, voltage follower.
Ma'am, slide is not changed, ma'am.
Strain gauge is an example of which device?
Transducer.
Yes, it is an example of transducer. Okay, next question. An instrumentation system does not include. What does the instrumentation system include? The block diagram we come across. Bharat Viji?
Yes, ma'am.
What is a block diagram we come across with three stages, right? What are those stages in instrumentation system? The first block diagram I've shown you. Anyone?
Transducer.
Input signal.
Yes.
Instrumental
amplifier.
Instrumentation amplifier. Automatic process controller.
automatic control.
Yes, indicator and automatic process controller. Yeah, here it is, they're asking for instrumentation system does not include. So you have a transducer is the first stage, instrumentation second stage, third process controller. Tester is not a, tester is not an instrumentation system. Next, transmission line are used for?
All of the mentions.
All of the above.
No. Signal transfer.
It is not doing input signal, not doing output signal. Yes, it is going
signal
to use
transfer.
For yes, signal transfer. Not for output signal or input signal and particularly use madala. It is generally used for signal transfer between units to unit or block to block. Okay. Next, the length of a transmission lines are longer than 10 meters, shorter than 10 meters, equals to 10 meters. I told you, the length of a transmission lines are dependent on the physical quantity to be measured and the system requirement. So what is the answer now?
B, ma'am.
None of the mentioned.
Yes, it is not, there is no specific length of a transmission line. That's why it is none of the mentioned. Okay. Why output of a transducer is not directly connected to indicator or display?
The input is fed directly.
Input is fed directly? No. Any other answer?
Ma'am, low level output will be produced, so it will be given to amplify.
Yes, yes. So here, transducer output is always low level. So that output has to be amplified. So that's why we are not connecting directly to the indicator or a display. So low level output is produced. What are the features of instrumentation amplifier?
All of the mentioned.
All of the mentioned.
Yes, so the first one is low noise, high gain, low thermal and time drift, all of the mentioned. So what about, what instrument is used to amplify output signal of a transducer?
Differential amplifier.
After transducer, what you're going to use? Are you going to use differential amplifier or instrumentation amplifier?
Instrumental.
Yes, block diagram mind really. So it is instrumentation amplifier. So in an instrumentation amplifier, using transducer bridge, which device measure the change in physical energy? I'm talking about particularly
resistive transducer.
Yes, we have discussed about resistive transducer. Next, the temperature of a thermistor increases when the value of its resistance remains constant, increase, decrease, depends on the heating material.
Decrease.
It is negative temperature coefficient, alva, thermistor. Oh. So,
yes,
temperature value jaasti aayitu antandre, resistance value ulta, reverse, inversely proportional. So, it is increases means resistance decrease. Okay. Photoconductive cell changes its resistance with change in temperature, material composition, incident radiant energy, change in elasticity.
Incident radiant energy.
Yes, it is a photosensitive material, photosensitive device or light dependent resistor. I can say photocell. It is going to be changes in its resistance when light incident on it. So incident radiant energy or light energy. So that is option C. So which material is used for photoconductive cell? I told you
cadmium
two materials.
Sulfide.
And one more I told
cadmium
you.
Cadmium sulfide.
Yes.
Silicon.
So silicon. Cadmium sulfide and yes. These two materials are used to fabricate photoconductive cell on a ceramic base. The last question, name the resistive transducer that varies its resistance on application of external stress.
Pain gauge.
Yes, it is not a photocell, it is not a light dependent, so it is a strain gauge. Sorry, it is spelling mistake, it is strain gauge. So elongation or compression will take in place when you apply a stress, or you can say force. The area will be reduced or expanded, that is strain gauge. Okay, so next we'll move on to the next class. Tomorrow we'll take up with the next application, that is the non-linear applications of op-amp, that is comparator and Schmitt trigger. So we're at the most end of the module. So tomorrow we're going to discuss about that. So I hope, is this clear with today's session?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just I want anyone to summarize the today's session.